A new day, a new problem, a new fixing, a new project. Why not? So I have to fix my mixture. This is a Phonic AM220. There was a problem with the power supply. It's supposed to deliver 2 × 14.8 volts, and the cable, the output cable here, got ruined. Well, I fixed this, I put everything back in place, I even checked the voltages here. Let's see together. As you can see, this one have a 3-pin connector. I have one here, and this is the plastic gap, you know, for having everything in place. I have one here, and another one. Checking the internet, I observed that this one here, let's call it number 2, it's the ground. The other one obviously is 14.8 volts AC, and another wing or round of 18.8 volts AC. So all the other rectifier bridge and so on, everything else, it's on the board. Now let's check for the voltages here, alternating current or voltage. So that's the ground, the middle pin. Okay, so we have 17 here, and the other one 17. Yeah, so the power supply, it's working as it should. I wasn't exactly sure about the connection here, but I found out, if you look at the board, that's the connector in here, and obviously ohmmeter on connectivity mode. If we check the motherboard power connector, this pin here, number 2, let's say, this one should be connected to the ground, and there we have, yes, that's the ground. This resistor here, it's a little bit discolorated, and it have a value of 3.3 ohms, and this one, yeah, it's looking like the resistor is okay. Normally this should work now, but I found something else. One of these connectors almost getting loose, and look at these two guys here. I have these two electrolytic capacitors, and they are blown. I can see some brown coloration or something, you know, came from the electrolytic capacitors. Probably when the connector here was up in the air or something, anyway, it's looking like we had more than this electrolytic capacitors can support. Let's check them with an ohmmeter here and here. Well, they are not in short yet, but they are not good either. So let's take them out. We have already marked for plus and minus flux. See, these are the main electrolytic capacitors, so they should be, these are absolutely kaput. But you know something, it was really interesting, except a vague hum noise, the mixer was totally working. It wasn't exactly an obvious say noise or danger or something, the mixer was working, but suddenly it had this strange noise. Let's see about this guy. First of all, this should be 1000 microfarads, and it shows me 290 for this one. And look at the AC array, 0.12, 120 ohms. They are absolutely ruined. Yeah, goodbye. Let me find two of these electrolytic capacitors. So I found me two of these guys. So they are not new, but they are okay. Hope. That's measuring. This is a very good measuring tool for this kind of jobs. Oh yes, of course. The AS here, it's perfect. 942 micro. That's the ground, the middle pin. And perfect. We are in the business. Let me plant the capacitors in place. Let me have some extra solder here. Over here, we are good here. Next one. So that's perfect, plus here, minus the other side. The second one goes like plus over there and minus here. Perfect. So this is back in place. Now all I can do is to connect the power supply and to check the voltages. Something else I have to say before, we have two power regulators here. The, I think there are like 7815, and here and here we should have two DC voltages, differential voltage. Yeah, we have the power on. This is nice. Let me check the voltages here on these two new electrolytics. 20 volts and 20.4 volts. This is absolutely perfect. So the ground is here. We should have 20 and minus 20. Well, everything looks fine. I can have a test. It's very easy to do that. I need a cable. Okay, now I have to disconnect the microphone. This one and this one are the outputs, for sure. I think so. Okay, now I'm taking out the microphone. The microphone is out from the camera, and we have mixer connected in. I will have the sound from my Panasonic photo camera, and let's see about the noise. Oh, there we go. Yeah, the input is very high now, so that's why I have this noise. This is okay, the general main. This one. Okay, this one needs a touch of contact spray. Here too, this too, this too. Okay, so I'll use this kind of contact electronic spray, just trying to put in as much as I can. From where? Here. And the other side. I'm not sure if I can reach the inside. I don't think so. Okay, so let's check if the spray had any impact. No, nothing. It's still noisy. I don't know how can I get into that. Okay, that's it. I'll try to open up one of these and to check to see if I can fix it. So I'll start with this one, because this obviously this is the most noisy. So I'm going to 400 degrees. 400 should be okay. So where is this guy? Right here. Flux. Okay. Now we have to take all this in the same time. Oh, very easy, pretty easy. And now let me see if I can dismantle that. Oh yes, of course, that will be so easy to dismantle. And some light. Oh yes, very easy. Now, let's clean this a little bit. Let's clean that with... Perfect. Here is okay. I don't think it's a good idea to use this kind of cotton pads. But I'll have some fat. Obviously too much. Okay, maybe a little bit of tension. Easy with that, because these are very sensible. And back in the case. Yeah, that's the right positioning. This. And we are good to go. Moment of truth. This really matter. Where are you? What have I done? Is this one? Oh man, I didn't want this. But as long as we are here, I think I can use that. Let me check that. So I have to take this, and this one was very noisy. Out. Soldering iron, 400 degrees. Flux. Perfect here. The other way. Some more. And we are out. And this one here now. The trick is to have a kind of like that. And it's out. And it's open. So we have two resistors inside. This one from here to here it's 1.95 mega ohms, and the other one, same story. So we have two resistors. This one in the middle, it's okay. Well, I really don't care if they're not interchangeable. Anyway, I'm here anyway, so just let me clean it. Nice. It's good. Let me have a little fat. And that is better than the factory. Hopefully. Yep, this one is running. Nice. So let's put these two guys back on the board, and to have an idea if it's really worth the effort to clean this, I mean to open and clean. Let me have this one first. So the legs are in place, six of them. Or even more, flux and heat. Well, guys, that is a problem, but it's not exactly a big one. We can fix that. So, we have too much heat here, so that's the reason why. It was my mistake. If you don't have that kind of special mesh, you know, for getting the extra soldering out of the place, we can improvise. Just take a piece of wire like this, it have to be copper of course, and try to get like that all the extra soldering, and I can tell you that it's working. Yeah, I heard you. And everything, here you go. Oh, this is a very clear bridge between these two points here, but we have another one. We are good to go. This is very okay like that. I don't even clean that because the flux, it will always keeping the moisture and corrosion away. Let's check for continuity. Everything's fine. And this one here goes to this one. Perfect. Number two goes to the ground. No. Number two comes here. Perfect. Good. This is the ground. And the last one here. This is better. Even better. But just want to be sure that. Very nice. That's it. A little bit of soldering here, good to go. Okay, let me have the other one in place. This need to be really well done here, because this one is the mechanical connection. Yep, yeah. Okay, so now let me have a little bit of checking here. Let's see if this really worked to do. So, power on. power, headphones. Much better. Okay, so here we are at the end of the fixing. That's the mixer back on duty. Everything is running nice and smooth. And guess what? That was the noisy one, if you remember. Now it's absolutely okay. So what can I say? If you have enough patience, you can give a try to clean all these potentiometers and have a new life for your gears. Okay guys, that's all for today. Thank you for watching, thank you for looking, and I hope this was useful. Don't forget to subscribe, please comment, like, and the most important thing is never forget to have fun. Bye bye.